Hi, welcome to this DCP web tutorial. In today's tutorial, I'm going to show you how to view your YouTube channel views in real time. So let's go ahead and open up my web browser. I'm already logged into my YouTube channel here. And what I'll do is click on Studio Beta here. When I click on Studio Beta, I'm going to go into Analytics here. And when I click on Analytics, I can scroll down and look at real time activity. So if I hover my mouse over on this point here, I can see that there's 16 people that have watched one of my videos in the last hour, so between 3 and 4, and right now it's 3:06. So in the last 6 minutes, I've had 16 views, for example. And it's worth looking at this analytics here, because if you note that roughly around 3 o'clock every day, so when I come and look at this information, I'm looking at it for a purpose, you could say. So roughly around 3 o'clock, between 3 and 5 o'clock, around this sort of time, I can see that I get the most amount of views. So normally I publish, I'll be tracking my views and how many people are looking at my videos and when is the best optimum time for me to publish a new video. And it works out around 3 p.m. UK time is where I get the biggest spike in my traffic. So that's where I tend to publish my videos, around that sort of time every day or every other day, depending on how many videos I have to publish. So here you can see a lot of other stats as well. So I will be going through some more detail in these stats, but you can see a general overview in the last 48 hours. That's quite interesting information. And here you've got the last, you know, the amount of minutes watched in the last 28 days. You can see how to remove the background from GIMP using GIMP 2.10. That's clearly got the most amount of minutes watched, over 100,000 minutes in the last 28 days. So if I hover my mouse over here again, a minute ago it said 16, and now it's updated to 19, so I've got another 3 views just by speaking to you as we're talking right now. And you can see it says it's updating live, right? So that's quite an interesting way to see information. There's all these other tabs up here. There's probably a bit too much to go through in this video. Really, I just wanted to show you the real-time activity. That was quite important, I think, to show you that. And here again, you can see 20. So as I'm speaking through this video, you can see that I'm getting views in real time, and this is sometimes worth tracking and seeing what is actually performing the best on your YouTube channel. So if you upload loads of videos about video editing and it's not getting much traffic and you're not seeing spikes here, but then you go and do something about graphic design and all of a sudden you start to see a lot more hits on your channel and a lot more hits on your video, then that kind of tells you roughly what sort of videos you should be making. And my channel is quite diverse. It's all about knowledge and sharing knowledge across a wide range of software applications. That's kind of my goal for my channel, is just to share all my knowledge as much as possible, learn new things myself, and then share that knowledge afterwards. I gain something because I learn something new, and then I get to share that with you. So it's a win-win situation. Let's have a quick look one more time, and now we're on 22. So at the beginning of this video, I think it was at 16. And now we're on 22, so we can see now it's on 24. It's increasing all the time, and it so happens to be the peak time, right? 3 to 4. If you look here, 3 to 4, that's roughly when I get the most amount of videos, or the most amount of views, should I say. And that's how I go about checking real-time activity on my YouTube channel. So let's minimize this. That's the end of this tutorial. I look forward to seeing you on the next DCP web tutorial.